you have to do the leash. Everybody, yep. The dogs that like no leaning, like that dog shouldn't be leaning. Yep. Use your leash. Do your leash skills if you have to. Dog gets, yep. Dogs that are sitting need to sit still. Dogs that are healing need to heal. Focus on the handler. I just did a big, huge thing on our Instagram Live. If you want to jump over to our Instagram Live after this, and you can see what we're doing. We just did a remote collar healing exercise. A lot of muzzle dogs here because we've got a lot of dogs here that don't do well with humans and they don't do well with dogs. And we take safety really seriously at these seminars. We want to make sure that we're really, really safe. We want everybody to move slow. If you find yourself talking too much to your dog, stop. All the dog is hearing is blah, 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 blah. Hey, Amanda, if everybody wants to wish Amanda a happy wedding, Amanda just popped on. She's getting married this Friday. She'll be a married woman. All right, next in line. There's Christopher. If anybody needs a good dog trainer down in South Carolina, click on Christopher's name. He'll take care of you. If anybody needs an underwear model, you can also click on Christopher's name. Probably the best looking man in the business. And then switch sides. And then relax that left arm. I know. It's habit. You want to rush through the exercise. You're welcome, Tiffany. This is hard, so it's a lot of pressure on the human, pressure on the dog. You're like, it's like, no, I'm too nervous. I'm too nervous. I'm worried about my dog misbehaving. I know you are. Everybody is. Everybody is. That's why we're here. If your dogs want to lie down, I am okay with that. So your dog is probably saying, you know what? I'm more comfortable lying down. Great, we'll take that for now. We'll take that for now. If they don't want it down, they don't have to down. But if they decide to down, I don't care for this exercise. Now we got Haley here. She's 10, 6-month-old dog. Rocking it. Group training module that we do at the seminar. We do a lot of one-on-one, and then on day two, we do a lot of group. Actually, yesterday, last night, the last 2 hours, we did some group stuff. Yeah, Haley's kicking ass over here. There we go. You're welcome, Mary. Thanks for watching. It actually means a lot to you that you're watching. It really does. And if your dog struggles with other dogs, they're not allowed to look at dogs for this exercise. And then we switch sides, walk down the next row. There we go. And if that dog wants to lie down, we just let it lie down. If you want to start practicing using your remote to get the dog to focus on the handler. I know. This is a good time to experiment with it. And there's Haley with her 6-month old German Shepherd killing it right there. Okay. And then loosen up the leash. Beautiful. So that was too much pressure right here. So, yep. Too much pressure. There we go. That's why we got muzzles on. Yep. Good job. It happens. That's why we got muzzles on dogs. That's why that one time a dog lunges. So why did that happen? That dog got excited with this nonsense. Got it? That's why if you've always got to be aware of like all your surroundings. And dogs feed on all this stuff. So this dog right here created a bunch of nonsense right here. This dog was paying a lot of attention to that. Yep. And boom. So then what you could do, Patrick, is knowing that your dog responds obviously to environmentals,
yeah.
It's like checking with your dog and you're going like, okay, hold on, my dog all of a sudden started loading. Mm-hmm. Well, even though he's not being reactive right now,
yeah.
Let me tell him to knock it off. Okay?
What
you did was perfect. What you did was just you stood there. The only thing you could have, because you got to worry about these other dogs that are here. So you have to keep that dog close to you. So you could have, the only thing you could have done a little bit different, but you got to watch out who's behind you, is you could have just backed out of the situation a little bit. Like, get out of the situation and then handle your shit over here. Let the dog process it. And then a lot of times people just hold the leash too taut, which I don't blame you. You don't want your dog to get loose. But at some point, you got to loosen the leash up so the dog can actually relax. Okay. Sort of what he was struggling with yesterday. Uh-huh. But now he's, you know, that right there was a quicker. Do we remember, Patrick, yesterday when his dog exploded? Yep. It went on for longer, right? Today, boom, he dealt with it, done.
Okay. Because if it was reversed, my dog would act just like his.
Got it. Got it. So what I told him to do is whenever if you see a dog explode even down there,
yeah.
Check in with your dog and like, whoa, hold on here. You're starting to think naughty thoughts. Knock it off.
Okay.
Pre-explosion. Don't wait till they explode. Because
okay.
What's going to happen is a dog's going to walk by. So now I want all, when it comes to walking around Patrick, I want everybody to just go around the end and go like this. Don't cut in front of him. And then you just keep an eye on your dog. That's all.
Down
in down, yeah. Just keep an eye on him, okay? That's all. All right, let's keep going. We handle things on the spot. That's, again, that's why we got muzzles on dogs. So they don't go after the handler. So here we go. So now he's got to keep an eye on his dog. So see how that dog's looking sketchy now? Boom. See that? Did everybody see that? So did you guys see what, so you just stimmed that dog, right? Patrick, when he looked? Beautiful. So that was, his dog was thinking naughty thoughts at that other dog, and he just said, hey, don't look. That's as simple as that. That's how subtle it is. That's the subtleness of all this stuff. Beautiful. A lot of this is about energy of the dogs. A lot of this. Beautiful job. Okay, I'm going to get off this so I can just help some folks. Okay. Yeah, I'll be in Southern California. Go to www.rvdogtrainer.com. All right, let me go so I can do some hands-on stuff, guys. Love you all. Bye-bye.